both of your papers. I have a question that is particularly specific to the BPO sector. I must admit, since I've been here nearly 2 years, my own view on the BPO sector in terms of its benefits for Australia have evolved. So, you know, initially I sort of perceived that it was just big Australian companies exporting jobs overseas and, you know, getting cheap and well-qualified labour here in the Philippines, therefore increasing the bottom line of that company for the benefit of the shareholders and consumers, etc., in Australia. Now, of course, there is still a large element of that, but since I've been here, I've encountered lots of Australian SMEs setting up BPOs here and really enabling them to compete with the bigger players in Australia to provide 24-hour operations, etc., in ways that they wouldn't be able to do so if they didn't have access to the BPO sector. And I have visited a lot of BPOs, Australian ones here in the Philippines, and been very impressed by the quality, enthusiasm, and indeed the level of skill that the Filipino workers have. But I'm just interested in whether you would consider BPO jobs, particularly Professor Clarete, to be quality jobs for Filipinos. Because, you know, while I can see clear benefits for Australia in utilising the BPO sector here and job and benefits for Filipinos in terms of access to employment, I wonder if you consider them quality jobs that are sustainable